Hello to you all, welcome to another educational material video. In this case I'm going to write through the purpose of optimization, how to properly optimize a strategy, at the same time how to properly look for overfit situations and how to avoid them in the future. So with a series of steps that I hope is going to help you implement them in any of the strategies you are using. So in this case I'm going to take DOMINUS, which is one of the premium scripts that we have. So let's take for example the V5. After this I will have to I will do that in the future anyway. So let's go for example ATH USDT. You know that in general I like to trade more on the big pairs time frames, like 1 hour, in 30 minutes 1 hour, and in general in DOMINUS these are kind of the time frames that you are supposed to be using. So anyway, let's get on with it. Let's remove, but I believe as a matter of fact we can actually take, because these are the default setting, no? So yeah, let's take something new. Let's take BTC USDT actually. And in this case let's go for something more stable. We can go for the 4 hours. Yeah, like I said, this is a tutorial video and I'm not going to care so much about the details. So first of all, in this case we have all the data, correct? So in this case all our data, you can see it starts from 20 August 2017. So I'm going to use it until 2021, so until 1/1/2021. And based off this, I'm going to start to do the optimizations. We are going to perform here the optimization. We are going to save a set. And after that, we are going to see how the new set is going to perform in the future. And I'm going to show you first the steps towards, the proper optimization in order to achieve faster and easier results. So first of all, in this case, I'm going to disable entirely the stop loss and the take profits. And at the same time, I'm going to do it both for the dynamic and for the fixed values. Okay, so here we have 100 as well. So now we have, now we have no stop loss, no take profit, and we are going to take a look into the only the indicator for the side market and for the trend. So in general, let's start from the rating for entry. I would say this is going to be the first values that we need to touch. So in this case we are going to only touch the first ones, the rating for entry and the rating for exit. So let's take a look into it. 55 looks like with 55 is going even better, I believe. 0.7 is going to be too much. Oh, actually it works okay with 0.7 as well, but I think it's too much, 0%, 0.5, 55, 6, 55. So this is going to be our initial entries. Something like this, taking into consideration that we are using such a big time frame and we have 136 candles. Let me calculate for a moment, please. So I have 136 multiplied by 4 divided by 24. So we stayed more or less like 3 weeks in a trade. Well, it can be possible, taking into consideration we are using the 4 hours and we are using a swing. So this is kind of valid data. Let me take a look a little bit more about the graph. So we can see initially we had kind of stagnancy in the first 23, so I believe this is going to be 2018-2019. This is also due to the fact that we have, the side market period in that moment. And then we have a very nice growth. You have a continuous growth. You see we have a stagnancy here as well. Then we had a growth, then again a stagnancy, and then we have a growth. So more or less what we are kind of seeing is normal, because it's taking into a fact the same movements that we had from the product itself. And now let's take a look and start with the optimization for on the side market. So we can see that the smooth data doesn't affect so much. We are going to take a look first at the BBC candles for source, for high, close, high low, high like C3. So looks like in this case the low is the best. Let's change a little bit the deviation first and see if we have some change with the deviation. No, looks like with 5 it would be even better. So yeah, do we want that much? We can go with 5. Let's take a look at 6. So this way we can have an even better deviation. Yeah, I believe this one it can work much better. So in general, from the deviation we are going to get the biggest result. And then the length, you know, it tends to be more or less close to the value that we initially set. Let's take a look for the short as well. Let's see some difference. In general, we have to use smaller deviation here, but not always. You know, it's not always happening this way. So it looks like low and low is going to be the key for both of them. In this case, so low and low. 3, 4, 5. So yeah, looks like more or less kind of here. Yeah, it's more or less is decent. Let's take a look as well at the Heikinashi. Without Heikinashi, we would have 23%. We reduce the drawdown by 10%, but we also reduce the profit by 15%. So let's go for now without Heikinashi. I want the safest one. So something like this. Let's change the rock value. Looks like no big changes to the rock, so it doesn't matter. And in the short, yeah, so we have no changes here. Let's go now for the correlation extra. No, sorry, correlation extra is not the sideways length and long short. So yeah, this one might do some changes, but yeah, one more data, so 4 or 5 maybe. Yeah, 5 was long. No big changes, I believe we can see, because we already have this type of movement. So yeah, sideways short, same stuff, no big changes. Long movement, but this one, if you want to go a little bit more and tweak it into detail, you know, I believe 45, it was 5, something like this, 9.5. Yeah, you can see if I go even bigger, it's going to grow even better. So yeah. Then we go for the 94, I believe 93 is going to be 92.5, 93, yeah, somewhere along here. The volume, let's take a look in the volume percentage. Yeah, so we have something like this, more or less. This is kind of some set of tools that we have. I'm not going to enter too much, like I said, because I'm interested mostly in the entire performance. So you see, now we are going to take a look at this data. So January, we can see that we made around 160%, 180% in 2018, 2017, 2019, 200%, 2020, 380. And now we are interested to see how it would perform in 2021. Big difference, because you see here is telling us 37% and here is telling us 79%, but it's telling us 79% because of this trade as well. So yeah, it's actually because this trade is not being taken into account. So we have around 80%, and what was the it was 33 100. It's a little bit actually below buy and hold. So these are the not of type of trades that I want to do. But then we have the other option in order to use the Heikinashi. So then again, not the best. So then we go back. We go back to where it was until the end. So you see, this type of setting, for example, was not good enough. So let's try something else. Let's go for the a bigger entry value. So let's go with 55. Maybe even lower than that. 45. 35. 35 too much. 55, okay, we can stick with 55. We can stick with this one. And now let's try again. 66%. So even lower. Okay, so no. Or maybe it's just I use too much data. I should use until 2020. You know? Let's take one more time, another look. So we went with Heikinashi. No, we were, yeah, until 2021. One more time. Yeah, we are like this until 2021. Let's go 45. Yeah, let's go something like this. I want to look for more trades. And I want to go like more to zero value. No, this one is too much. There we go. 10, maybe 2. Okay, so 10 it is then. So we have this 10. We will have this exit, but this exit is going to start on February. So I want to take into account this entry. So in order to take into account this entry, I want to enter from December. Okay, so we will start on December. So we have this. Now let's actually take a look at the take profits and so on. So let's start, for example, with the 20%. Not the best. 10%. 30%. Okay, so maybe even more than that, 40%. No. So let's go with 20% one more time. 10% on the stop loss, just to have something. 5% and 3% because they used to that's too low. So this one, I don't know. Maybe instead go with the fixed value. So let's go for example 0.3, 0.2. So looks like actually it would be even better without, you know. So it should be even better without. So like I said, let's go until so we have this last entry. Last entry would be on 18 December. So we have here until 10/12/2020. Let's take it like this. So this is will be our final result, more or less. So we can see we have 9,500. We would have 180, 150, 240, 300, and then we take from 1/1/2020 until the present day. Well, 31/12/30/31. No, but it's 12. And we can see in this case, yeah, because we had this big movement that was not being taken into account. And you can see right now that we go actually for 180%. So more or less, it's making this data, it's making it valuable. You know? So this is going to be kind of sort of set of parameters that should help with the optimization. So yeah, then of course, after you have these, and you can see, then you can go in the take profit as well. But once again, I would recommend to do the same setting for the take profit during when you are doing the training period, you know. And after that, with the other one, you should enter and do the forward test, to say like this. By doing this, you kindly assume more or less that a set of data that you had in the past at the same time is going to perform well in the future, although not entirely because the market is unpredictable. But then you can take into consideration things like, for example, look, we had a big crash and it was able to predict the big crash when it was 55, and it's actually give us a 30% profit in this case, you know, with the crash. Even though in the past, for example, in 2018, 19 and 20, I don't think we have something like that. Or maybe we did. Maybe I'm wrong right now. But yeah, you know, there are this type of situation that they can help. So more or less, that's how you are supposed to do a proper optimization, you know, for the strategy. This and any other strategy, you should always use a testing time range, and after that, you know, you use a forward time range. So yeah, and others again, you know, you want to see the graphic. You can see more or less the graphic, it's decent. Why doesn't mean it's decent? If I take any other any point, specific point, you know, from the graph, you can see that it's growing, you know, how the fuck it's called, periodically, you know, like it's not one moment and then, you know, bam. Yeah, you see here we have a moment, but then again it's going down. Like here we have a moment, it's going down, we have a moment, it's going down, we have a moment, it's going up, then again it's going down. So, you know, there are all these types of things that you should take into account. And then if I take the let's take the entire range actually, from 2017 until today, you see 24,000, you can see the same. You can see we have a graph, we have a period, because we have stagnancy, we have a growth, we have a stagnancy, we have a growth, we have stagnancy, we have growth, growth, and this growth massively is because, you know, of this bull moment that we had in this year. But yeah, overall, you know, overall, this would be, for example, a decent set that you can use. And if you will take into account, for example, it was in 2017, it was 4,000, and right now it's 61,000. So you will have, like, by holding just 1.5%, you can see that we beat it by a huge margin. You know, we beat it by almost 15-20 times we beat it in this case. But yeah, of course, you have a lot of cost, fundings, blah blah blah, so let's put half of that. But let's put even less than that. What I can tell you is that you'll make at least minimum a double, triple of so what we had been just by holding. So yeah, there you have it. I hope you enjoyed, and see you next time with another lesson. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.